Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at stopping junk mail. Now, there are many ways to prevent junk mail from reaching your inbox. And you may be tempted right away, if you're using Apple Mail, to go right to Mail Preferences, go to Junk Mail, and then enable junk mail filtering and leave the burden all on your email client program, Apple Mail, to filter it out here at the last minute just before it hits your inbox. But what you should actually do is, before you go here, this should be the last resort, you should go to your ISP, your internet service provider that provides you with the email service, and try to set up spam filtering there. Now, if you use, say, Gmail, then spam filtering is automatic, and it's very good in Gmail because it's basically crowdsourcing the whole thing. Now, junk mail or spam is completely unsolicited email. If it's something that, say, you signed up for but you no longer want to get it, it's so important you don't use the junk mail button here or in Gmail or anywhere else, but instead use the unsubscribe button that you find at the bottom, and you'll find this in any legitimate piece of email. So look here first, see if you find this, and then hit that button, and that'll cleanly get you off without penalizing the company that sent out the email. After all, you were the one that asked for it, so you need to do the responsible thing and ask to not get it rather than jumping right to the spam button. Now, I highly recommend that you use a transportable email address, like one from Gmail or even Yahoo or a Microsoft account, something that you can have no matter what ISP you're using. If you use an account from, say, Comcast or Verizon or any provider like that where they're providing the physical connection to the internet, you can very easily lose that email account by simply moving. If you move to another neighborhood, you could find that you can't get that same service there, and now you no longer have that email account. So it's a bad idea to ever use your ISP's email, and you should use something you can transport. Apple's iCloud service, for instance. It doesn't matter where in the world you are or which provider you've got for internet, you can always use that. And those services generally have better spam filtering. However, if you are stuck for some reason using a service like Comcast, you can very easily search, say, for Comcast junk mail settings or Verizon junk mail settings, and come up very quickly with links to information or maybe directly to the settings for junk mail for setting it up on the server so that spam never hits your inbox. And you should set that up before you even consider setting up junk mail filtering on your Mac itself. So now let's look at your last line of defense, and that's the junk mail filtering inside of the Apple Mail app. You go into preferences there, and under junk mail, this is where you can enable it, and you have several different settings. So of course you want to set it up so that if the sender's in your contacts, that it won't be sent there. You want to try to basically prevent false positive. That's what most of this stuff is for. Now, the junk mail filtering in Mail will learn as you use it. So as you mark things as spam, it will get better and better. But of course, it's only learning from you, as opposed to, say, using Gmail or something where it's learning from millions of other people who are marking things as junk mail and marking them as not junk mail as well. So it's not going to be as good as some other filtering solutions out there, but you can still use it, and you can still set this up so that it doesn't get as many false positives. In addition to using just the regular junk mail filters, you can also set up rules here. So a rule can take something into account, like having something in the subject and having some text in there, and then immediately move it to junk. So if you find something is slipping through the junk mail filters all the time, just like with Gmail, you can set something up here that automatically filters it to go out right to junk mail. So to have it learn, you want to select the email and hit this button here, which marks it as junk mail. You can select multiple messages. So you can use the shift key to select a range, or you can use the command key to select multiples. And once you've selected multiples, you can mark them all as junk there. But it's just as important to go into your junk mail folder, and if you see something that's not junk, then you can give it the thumbs up and it will mark as not junk and learn from that as well. So you want to kind of do both to improve it. And you just want to check your junk mail folder every once in a while anyway to look for false positives.